Hello YouTubers and welcome to this T4D. Now in this T4D I'm going to do a quick catch up about what I've been doing in the last couple of weeks. I'm jumping in with this T4D now because there's some time sensitive topics. There are two Kickstarters, one's about to end in 3 days. It has already met its goal, but we'll talk about that a little bit later. And then there's a fair amount of equipment, I'll call it mailbag kit, that has arrived from various vendors which you may be interested in. So I'll introduce you to that, and I'll tell you about the review progress of the Keysight 3000T oscilloscope. I've had this in my hands for a couple of weeks now, and I've literally stopped video production because I've been chatting to Keysight about a few bits and pieces, but I'll tell you about that in a moment. One of the first items I want to bring to your attention is, you know, Franky's been selling these inline USB power monitors, and they've been very popular and very successful. What has happened though is that on eBay, there have been other eBay sellers who have literally gone and scraped all his work. So all his eBay store, all his text and everything about these, even using the link to my video, and then selling these on their sites. Now, Franky's gone to a lot of effort in terms of translating the manual and providing further instructions for it. He's even and we'll have a closer look at, he sent me a programmer where we're going to go through a firmware update. So he's been keeping in touch, making sure he's keeping on top of the firmware updates. He's also sent me a shunt. So there's a slight hardware update and another improvement to this. I must say, I'm really impressed by the guys who produce this because they continue to improve it where they can. So it's a service mount resistor, a new shunt for this, and that we'll install in one of the videos soon. But his request is, please consider supporting him, as say, for all his time and effort, these other guys are just scraping off his work and basically trying to undercut him in what he's doing. So if you are going to purchase one of these, please do support the good man. Then let's talk about that Kickstarter. There's a good gent, Matt, who approached me a little while ago now, and he's got a company called TechTight, and he's gone and produced something called the Logit. So it's L-O-G-I-T. And I'll just take you over to the Kickstarter page. This is a real-time inline power logging meter for test equipment, primarily for USB and power over Ethernet, but it does have terminals as well, so you can connect other things in line. You can connect it and log to a PC, or it has an SD card built in. So when I saw this device, I was very excited about it because this is getting very close to what I would deem to be a nice piece of equipment to do power measurement or energy measurement on batteries or devices. And I reckon this could be easily developed in perhaps to a proper bench tool. Although even in its current form, it could be used as a bench tool. So he's already exceeded his goal. Currently, as I talk to you, there are 3 days left to the end of it. By the time this is up, there'll probably be only 2 or 1 day. So if you are interested in backing him or perhaps getting an early unit, then go over to the Kickstarter because there'll just be enough time. But at least he's made his goal and he said he will send one to me. So I'll have one and then we'll definitely do a review on that. I say, I love devices like that. Then Dacian of Electrodacus has gone and produced a second version of his SBMS solar battery management system. So it's the solar charger and the lithium ion battery management system, or it can do capacitors. It's got a higher rated capacity. That Kickstarter is going to start, I think, later this month. But on his website, you'll be able to see all the details. He goes through all the improvements and enhancements that he has done. And he also gives a nice little interesting side-by-side of lithium battery technologies versus lead-acid battery technologies. A very interesting read. So I urge you to go there. You'll have seen the review that I did on his previous unit, a beautifully built unit. And I expect his second version is going to be as successful. So if you want to get in early on that Kickstarter, then certainly just keep an eye open because that'll be starting off at the end of the month. So just a little bit of background, these last few weeks or since the new year started, I've been fairly busy. I've obviously been working on that power quality, single phase power quality tutorial. That's one I did ahead of doing the three phase motor and the control systems to that. It made more sense to start off with the power quality and single phase before doing that. There's part 3 of that will be posted after this. And then since I completed that, I've been evaluating the Keysight 3000T series oscilloscope, which was sent to me. So this is a loan unit. This is their top of the range model. It's the 1 gigahertz unit. It's got the 16 digital channels and it's got all the software options enabled. It's not a cheap beast by any means. And I'm going to talk about that because in the review, what I highlight is that a large part of the price comes because of the bandwidth, the 1 gigahertz bandwidth. And that's an interesting intro into the unit that I received from Analog Arts. Now, literally 10 minutes ago, as I was preparing for this video, I just did a quick search online for this to get to understand the pricing and get a bit of information. And I see that Sharia from the Signal Path yesterday has done a review on this. And I haven't had the time to watch it, but from the comments, it doesn't look promising, because this has got a 1 gigahertz, so-called 1 gigahertz bandwidth. And I know that for that bandwidth, you pay a lot of money. Now this costs $1,200. The bandwidth alone on a unit like this, the full price of this is around $18,000. $9,900 of that is dedicated just because of the bandwidth. So that's going to make it very interesting for me now when I have a look at this Analog Arts unit. For the price point of around $1,200 with all the functionality it has, it would seem promising. However, I'm going to look at Sharia's review of this unit. I'll put a link below if you haven't yet seen it, so I'm sure you'll get a good insight into the unit from his review. But I'll put it through its paces myself just to see how it does or doesn't perform. I do have the entry-level unit too, so I can make some comparisons between the two. Now, what I've also done, and you can't see so clearly in the background, to help me with reviewing these scopes, because I'm going to be doing the Keysight side by side with the MDO-3000 from Tektronix, because they are direct competitors, and Keysight are now trying to challenge, I think, the Tektronix in terms of doing time correlated measurements, which is quite interesting, and I'll highlight that in the review. But to go and test their bandwidth, I certainly didn't have any signal generator that could do that, so I went and found about 10 or 15 year old Agilent. It's the E4421B. It goes up to 3 gigahertz. So that's been a great tool for the evaluation. I've also then got a very old Agilent vector signal analyzer. So it's very similar to a spectrum analyzer, but it's specifically designed for things like GSM, Edge, Wi-Fi to troubleshoot and test those devices so you know where your signal is. So it's got a very narrow 10 megahertz range in which it can actually do a scan, but it's very powerful and it does very accurate measurements for that narrow range. Although when I say narrow range, that's what you can scan to. It can go up to 4 gigahertz. So for the money off eBay, it was a very good buy for me, but those tools we'll look at in a future video. So in terms of things that have arrived, I'll just quickly show you the stuff that Franky sent me. This little unit is used to program or update the firmware on his USB power monitor. So there is new firmware, but you do need a device like this to go and do the update. And as I said, I'll do a separate video going through that process. He sent me nice detailed instructions. So again, Franky, I really appreciate that. He sent me all the bits and pieces to be able to do that. Just a note, if you do happen to do this yourself, whether you change this shunt resistor or whether you do the programming, you do need to recalibrate this. So you do need a reasonably accurate 5-volt source and 2-amp source to do the calibration. But we'll go through that, and then there's a surface mount resistor, as I've noted, which is a replacement for the existing shunt and apparently improves performance. So we'll double check that out when I go through the whole process. And then leading into that, because Franky mentioned that it may be handy to have 2 soldering irons, I was contacted by a company called IsoTip. They do portable tools or tools which you can use out in the field, whether they're gas powered or rechargeable. And they sent me this quick charge soldering iron. I've not ever used a portable or rechargeable soldering iron before, so I thought a great opportunity when I get around to doing Franky's work, I'm going to try this and we'll see how well it works. The model number they've sent me is the 770. Now I'll just quickly open it up so we can see what it looks like. Oh, interesting. So in the lid, it comes with 2 tips. One has got a little chisel and the one's a little more kind of a flat point. So there's a little book of instructions. It's got a little light. Interesting, it's an incandescent light. So funny to see an incandescent light bulb these days and everything's going LED. But nonetheless, that's what's there. You obviously plug the soldering tips into this point, and this is the charging station. So you plonk it down in there,
you charge it, and then you can go off and use it portable. So let's just have a quick look. I'll see if they mention how long it does last for once you've actually charged it. So it says the quick charge and power pro units charge in about 3 to 4.5 hours. Using the wall plug transformer, charging time is 12 to 16 hours. I can't see anywhere where it mentions how long you'll have to use it in its mobile mode, but that is something we'll certainly check during review. But anyway, big thanks to them for sending it to me, and we'll certainly put it through its paces and see how well it does work. Then I had this company, Lascar, contact me, and I know this company when I was in South Africa. Once I was doing a project, and I was researching some panel meters, and I found these on RS Components, and they were really, really, really handy. The one nice thing about, the ones which are pictured here on the top of their catalog, is that one of the challenges when you're trying to install a panel meter in an enclosure is normally they're either square or more rectangular, and cutting out those shapes can be an issue. So having round panel meters, or these ones where you just have to drill a single hole, can be really handy. They aren't cheap. I remember them being, you certainly pay, I think, a bit more of a premium price for these meters, but they are very nice. What they have sent me is this Panel Pilot Ace. So I'm gonna open the box and have a look at it now. I got one of these or something similar from RS Components a long time ago as well. And what they've gone and sent me, this is a development board or a test board for it. So this should provide some nice little bit of research, because you can configure one of these to whatever you want to do for your project. It's really got a lot of functionality. They are really, really, really neat and nice, it has to be said. Just quickly take the cover off. So I haven't had a lot of time to see what this board does, but it looks like a prototyping type board, because you can, there are all kinds of ways that you can configure this unit to obviously do what you want. You can set up the display with all kinds of options. And this area over here is for your prototyping. And then over here, this unit plugs directly into the board. If we have a look at the connectors, so all the connectors, these match up. It plugs into the board, and you can obviously set up your circuit and then have this all rigged up so you can see how it's gonna hang together. So a really nice setup by the looks of things, but we'll certainly take a closer look at this once I get it onto the bench for review. Then one of the items that HT Instruments sent me, which we're going to be having a look at soon, is this phase checker and sequence detector. Now you'll know I got that motor, that three-phase motor, which we're going to do the tutorial on. And one of the issues that you can have when you're wiring up three-phase is if you get the phases incorrect, you get the rotation on the motor is going to go the wrong way. And you do get phase checkers to do that, and sometimes they can be fairly advanced pieces of equipment, or they can cost a fair bit of money. So what HT Instruments did, they went and developed this non-contact voltage detector, which has got a very sensitive detector in the tip, and it will show you whether you've got your phases connected correctly. And they patented this, they develop all their own tools in-house. I say it's a small Italian company, and I was really chuffed when I got to meet the gents at the Solar Power International. So this is one of the little devices that we'll check.
And then also, just out of interest, I'll show you what else they've sent me. But someone mentioned the other day that my lab was looking a little bit messy, and I ended up having a whole lot of boxes and everything on the floor. So I've got a little more organized, I've got some shelving. This is my own bits and pieces where they're pending videos which I'm working on. So the stuff is all lined up over there, like the power supply. I've got another Keithley 179A meter Sean kindly sent me. I've got one on the bench which I've actually managed, which was working, and I've calibrated really, really nicely. So that's set up on the bench over there. That we'll get to soon, hopefully, once I've got through the review of the Keysight oscilloscope. But then what I wanted to show you was the other equipment that HT Instruments have sent me. So I've already mentioned, and in part three of the power quality tutorial, I quickly do a quick short demonstration of their HT9022, their power clamp. I'm going to do a full review of that. But when spring arrives and I can get to my solar panels, they've sent me some really, really nice PV test equipment. It's designed to set up a whole string of panels. You can also check the efficiency of your inverter when you've got, say, DC coming into the inverter and versus the AC going out. So some really nice equipment, and that will check, say, as soon as the snow has disappeared, I can get to my solar panels. We'll have a look at those and see how well they work. And there are two units. There's a unit there for testing PV and another one over there. Then just before we end off, so last but certainly not least, there's a French gent who's a refrigeration engineer, and often he'll send me links to meters which he thinks might be interesting for review, and I've been keeping a tally of those. The last link he sent to me was a piece of equipment I hadn't heard of before. It's by a company called Martindale, and it's a clamp meter, but it's an insulation tester and a clamp meter, so apparently fairly unique. And I checked, and Barry, my sponsor, happened to have this, so he's kindly sent this to me. And I just want to say, I'm now going into my fourth year of doing this full time, and Barry has been along for two of those. So I'm now entering my third year with Barry as being a sponsor. And that's a huge thing. I would not be able to afford to run this channel and do what I do without the support from Barry of tester.co.uk. So if you are based in the UK, do consider going to his website. I know he's got a fairly extensive catalog of equipment. There's loads of things. He does right across all the brands, which is really helpful for me because there is a wide range of equipment that he does do. And I mean, just as an interesting note, last year was actually quite tough for me in terms of, for one, moving, settling into this house, flooded basement. I invested a lot of the earnings which came out of this channel back into buying equipment, things like setting up the solar power for those tutorials, going to Las Vegas. So I, at the end of the day, put very minimal money back into the household to support what my wife's doing as well. So having Barry as a sponsor is a huge thing. Now this year, fortunately, I've received a lot more equipment, so there's a lot less that has to come out of my pocket, which certainly makes a life a lot easier for me. But having Barry's support there is a big part of it. The other thing which he sent me, I asked specifically for, and these weren't that expensive, were a set of electrician's screwdrivers. Now, what we're going to do is open up my DB board at some point in time, one, to show you how my inverter and the whole solar power system is wired up, particularly with a split phase system. But I'm also going to go through the safety issues related to working with electricity and in a DB board. And up until now, when I've been working my DB board, I've been wrapping my screwdrivers in insulation tape. Many, many layers, because if you only wrap one layer, it takes one little nick and you'll be through. But that's not the right way to do it. So he sent me these. So when I do start the safety videos on working in a DB board, I'll show you these. But very, very nice. They've got nice insulation, which is nice and robust, and you're not just going to cut through it easy. Far safer working in a DB board with something like this than a plain screwdriver. But anyway, thanks very much for your support, and I'll catch you soon for the next video. Cheers.